Okay, Trey, you saw this where?
The Athletic.
Okay. And it was places this NHL superstar could end up.
That's right.
Superstar is Matthew Tkachuk. And how many teams were listed?
They had a list of 7 potential destinations for Matthew Tkachuk.
Our audience is smart enough to know that we typically spin it local, and hence we would not be bringing this up.
Unless
the Red Wings were listed. I suppose we could bring it up. If they weren't listed, then we'd be screaming from mountaintops, why aren't they listed? So the Red Wings are listed along with St. Louis Blues, the Nashville Predators, the New Jersey Devils, the New York Islanders, the Vegas Golden Knights, and the Dallas Stars. Of those teams, Gator, the Red Wings have the third most cap space. You have to sign, right?
Right, and they just spent a bunch of money in the offseason.
But the question is, does Detroit have the material to send back to Calgary and get them to play? Here's what the story says about Detroit. The Wings are in a good spot. They have the cap space and roster construction that allow them to accommodate Tkachuk immediately. That's back. More than good enough to net him on the first round. They're short on established young NHL players with remaining years of team control that they'd be interested in trading at least. Most interesting, realistic package for Detroit. Again, this is to get Matthew Tkachuk. A win-now player like Tyler Bertuzzi or Jacob Vrana. Younger pros like defenseman Noah Prodek, suggested this trade, we might hang up.
I mean, I would probably roll my eyes and go, do you think that's it? That'd be enough to get him?
Yep.
Now, look, the Athletic throws names out there. It is what it is. But the fact that these are the names they threw out there.
Yep.
I mean, I love Tyler Bertuzzi. I don't want to move on from Tyler Bertuzzi, but if it's going to cost me Jacob Vrana, your pick of the Phillips, some prospect they have that's not Edvinson
or Casper
and a future first pick. Didn't they say first? Just some future group of picks.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'll give you a first round pick.
And I'd give you 2. Honestly, okay. I don't want to. Of course, I'd do it for 1. But if you told me that the Red Wings move their next 2 first round picks, a prospect not named Edvinson and Casper, one of the Phillips and Bertuzzi, Matthew Tkachuk.
Let's
keep this going.
And by the way, they've got more cap space by trading away some of these players.
So I meant up because he says that's where he'll sign, and Calgary works out a trade.
It mentions the Devils. The Devils have $9.6 million in cap space, and they have the prospect pool ranking of 4, which is pretty good.
Yep. It's what, New Jersey, Dallas, Detroit. There might be one more that's kind of close in terms of prospect pool and cap space.
Because in cap space, Islanders have a lot more than the Red Wings, but their prospect pool is 31.
Yep.
Vegas is 22. Dallas is 10. So. Yeah.
Anyway, I'll just say this. Here's why this feels like it could be in play. Because Yzerman is positioned to do it. Yzerman is constantly talked about flexibility. He didn't jump in on Johnny Gaudreau. He didn't spend all the cap money. And it's everybody thinks Yzerman at some point is going to take the big swing. This would be the big swing that even after free agency, he still is in position to make a move like this.
This would be a massive swing.
Yep.
A player who's 24 won't turn 25 until December. A player who is coming off clearly his best season in the NHL. He played all 82 games last season and had 104 points, including 42 goals. He has previously had a 34-goal season back in 18-19. Last year, he played 56 games, had 43 points in 56 games, and he changed that to 104 points in 82 games. He had a hell of